that we all gather here this evening at this vigil of the Nativity of our Lord, we are reminded that there are many beautiful Christmas traditions in the churches and in each of our families. Some of us may have experienced these traditions for some time, and maybe for others, meeting today is a start of a new tradition. Some of the traditions are authentic, going back to the first Christmas. These are the traditions we learn about in Scripture. Hearing about the baby Jesus being born in the stable in Bethlehem and laid in a manger, and the angels singing, "Glory to God in the highest, and the shepherds," when they proceed to go and worship the Christ child. Other traditions are beautiful and carry a certain romance, but most come from popular cultures rather than historical accuracy. The concept of blending Christmas and snow, for example, or a white Christmas, comes from a celebration of Christmas in the Northern European cultures. And of course, Bing Crosby. Many of our families have special Christmas traditions, such as which Christmas Mass we attend, or when the children lead everyone in singing a Silent Night. There are so many beautiful Christmas traditions, so many beautiful Christmas carols and hymns, that it might seem to be a shame that the Christmas season is so brief. At times it might seem that we don't have the time to enjoy them all. In 2013, a U.S. Catholic magazine conducted an informed survey of its readers about their Christmas spirit. The readers acknowledged the specialness of the Advent and Christmas season to them, but 27% also said that they didn't really appreciate it because they were so busy. Some even dreaded the Christmas rush. So how can we keep the Christmas season joyful and meaningful? Certainly by spending time with our family, our friends, and our traditions, and by keeping the reason for the season in mind. To help us remember that, some of us even have bumper stickers or flags in our front yard telling everybody that Jesus is the reason for the season. That's wonderful, because it reminds us of why we have Christmas in the first place. It also reminds us to keep Christmas alive all year by celebrating the presence of the Lord in our lives. A while ago, I read of a concept very close to that same, but with just a little different perspective. Simply put, it is that we are the reason for the season. We are the reason for the eternal Word of God, the second person of the Trinity, was sent by the Father to take on human flesh through the Virgin Mary. God saw on mankind that we were stumbling in the darkness of a pagan world. He sees how we are also tempted to walk aimlessly in life. Jesus came and continues to come to each of us to give us this light, this meaning, this purpose, this goodness, this beauty. The baby that was born that blessed night was the greatest of all gifts. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that every man might not perish, but might have eternal life. Jesus gave himself totally to us. We are the reason that he came down to her in his human flesh. We are the reason that he suffered and that he died. He gave us a reason to live. He gave us the promise of eternal life. Jesus is the reason for the season. Yes, that's true. But we are also the reason for the season. He comes to us each Christmas day and every day of our lives to unite us to his life. Whether we are busy parents with little children, or a dedicated single looking to serve, to spend as much time as available to serve God, of a religious or priestly vocation. When we are older people, whose children have moved on with their lives, for senior citizens who are living each day we have left to serve God the best we can. Our lives are ultimately about our life with God. Nothing else matters. Only God, only His life, only His love matters. This is the reason why He came. We are the reason why He came. Jesus is a Christmas gift of the Father to us. We are the gift of Jesus Christ to His Father. May you and your families have a holy and blessed Christmas. And may we all keep the gift and spirit of Christmas alive through our union with our loving God. Merry Christmas.